He has never promised you a trouble-free life. Rather, He'll be there with you in your storm. 34th week in ordinary time, 25th of November, Thursday reflection. My dear friends, being with the Lord does not mean that you are out of trouble. Never. But then it's different when you are with the Lord and when you are without the Lord. We are in a world where evil one is in control. Death, calamity, destruction, persecution is part of our life. So when you look at the sun, when it is far, when it is in the horizon, and you look at it and enjoy it, because sun is far. But then when sun is perpendicular, just above you, you cannot look at it because it's so close. Then it's hard. So when you journey with the Lord, I mean, if you don't challenge the evil one, if you compromise with him, with double standards, of course you will enjoy life. You will please the Lord and the evil one also. So then if you have this life of compromise, then you will enjoy life. Enjoy in inverted commas, I mean. But then if you want to give the fuller consent, a big complete yes to the Lord, you have to pay a price for that. So initially, your prayer life, your journey would be really enjoyable. But then that joy is different when you go deeper. We find in the book, we find in the life of Daniel, a righteous man, and he's a wise person who interprets dreams and all that. He had the presence of God and he enjoyed his prayer. So it was a time of a pagan king, and it was a time where people wanted to persecute the Israelites, so-called chosen people of God. So they amend all the laws and arrange in a very cruel way to kill them. So they were targeting Daniel. Though he was good with the king, he won the acceptance of king, yet they were plotting against him. So it was a law. They should not pray to their own gods. But Daniel, for three times, he was stern and firm that he should pray to him. And he was praying. Come what may, he was praying. That's how he was caught when he was praying. My dear friends, you come to a point, the challenge would be not only without you, but then it's also within you. This persecution should come from within you. Okay, of course, there are people who disturb our prayer. Rather, the situation, devil will reuse your financial crisis. So even Sundays you need to work overtime because you have to earn. So there are different strategies they will use to disturb your prayer. You have to remember the evil one's main focus is your connection. So that's how you have to pay a price for this. There's no other way. So even within you, you feel drowsy, you feel lethargic, you feel sleepy, and you don't have the mood of praying, you don't feel God. So that's another way of attacking him. So as Daniel was curtailed from his freedom to be with the Lord, even you and I, we are challenged. My dear friends, King was trapped in a way, and he was pushed by the law, the leaders, the cruel ones, to execute, to kill Daniel. and it was a hard time. So this is how he was taken. Daniel, who is one of the exiles from Judah, pays no attention to you, O king, or the injunction you have signed, but makes his petition three times a day. Then the king, when he heard these words, was much distressed and set his mind to deliver Daniel. Even the king couldn't do that, as Pilate wanted to save Jesus, isn't it? And of course he tried all the ways, means possible, but he was trapped. My dear friends, it's difficult. If you love the evil one in your life, if you started compromising, you will come to a point where you will kill the connection. That happened with Samson, with Delilah. That happens with Herod and Herodias. That happened with David and Bathsheba. So they were entertaining sin without taking that harsh decision of killing the enemy, of saying no, a difficult no, but yet you have to be firm in that no. So he was helpless. He was helpless, that king was helpless, and he was breaking rest. He could not sleep, and he was fasting throughout the night. And he tried to save Daniel, but he could not save him. He was so sad. Then the king commanded that Daniel was brought and cast into the den of lions. The king declared to Daniel, "May your God, whom you serve, continually deliver you." And a stone was brought and laid in the mouth of the den. And the king sealed it with his own sign and with the sign of the Lord's, that nothing might be changed concerning Daniel. So it was a difficult time. The king went to his place and spent the night fasting. No divisions were brought to him, and sleep fled from him. Then at the daybreak, my dear friends, Gospel speaks about the destruction in the end of time. Jerusalem would be surrounded by armies. Desolation has come near. And let those who are in Judea flee to mountains. And let those who are inside the city depart. And let not those who are out in the country enter it. For these are the days of vengeance. So it was a difficult time. For there will be great distress upon the earth and wrath against his people. They will flee, we will fall by the edge of the sword, and we will be led captive among all nations, and Jerusalem will be trampled underfoot by Gentiles. And there will be signs in sun and moon and stars, and everything in the world will be shaken. Whether you are in connection or not, you have to go through this phase of time. A difficult time where you are so much broken. Like Daniel was shut up in the lion's den, my dear friends. But then, it's not the circumstance, but by your faith, you are saved. Daniel was praying, praising God, and he said, and he was saved completely. O king, live forever. My God sent his angels and shut the lions' mouths. They have not harmed me, because I was found blameless before him. And also before you, O king, I have done no harm. It's beautiful. If you stay in connection, he will come to your life in the right time, and he will save you completely. Have faith. Don't lose heart. He is there in your storm with you, my dear friends. Amen. May God bless you.